Hi, I'm Ber Salazar and we are here in Master Electrician's Review Notes to review basic electrical principles, electrical code commonly asked in board exam, and do some simple electrical calculation. Today, I would like to discuss the benefits of reviewing 10 questions a day on the Philippine Electrical Code, especially for those preparing for examination. First, this focused approach enables individuals to gradually build their knowledge and understanding of the code. By tackling only 10 questions daily, you can reduce information overload and allow you for better long-term retention of the material. Second, consistent daily practice is a key to reinforcing learning. This kind of approach enables reviewers to develop a strong and easier recall of information during the examination. Third, a manageable routine like reviewing 10 questions a day fosters discipline and creates a habit of continuous learning. Establishing a habit is crucial for success in any professional field, not just for examination. I encourage you to consistently review 10 questions a day on the Philippine Electrical Code to increase your chances of success in the examination. By adopting this strategy, you can ensure the passing of the Philippine Electrical Code examination. How can you review PEC1 easily? That's possibly your question. Well, my answer is if you want to eat an elephant, you cannot eat it in whole. You need to eat it bite by bite. In application, why not review PEC1 10 questions daily? That's actually 300 questions in a month. And that is not bad. Let us review 10 PEC questions today, okay? Okay, let's proceed to review the question. Here it is. What type of electrical conductors has a trade name moisture-resistant thermoplastic? We are asking for a trade name. If you read Chapter 3 of PEC, you can remember the answer. The correct answer is TW, letter A. Let me explain further so that retention can be built in your memory. TW is a type of electrical conductor that has a trade name of moisture-resistant thermoplastic. This type of wire was thermoplastic insulation and is commonly used in wet location where moisture resistance is required. However, THW is another type of electrical conductor that has thermoplastic insulation, but it is not specifically designed for moisture resistance. That's why it is not the answer. On the other hand, THW and THWN is a type of electrical conductor that has thermoplastic insulation and is specifically designed for moisture resistance. It is similar to TW, but has a nylon coating for added protection against moisture. Therefore, it is not also the answer. Our final answer, based on the question, is a conductor that has a trade name moisture-resistant thermoplastic is TW. So, it is letter A. I hope I explain it better. Our second question is a little tricky. The PEC question is, for the purpose of lightning protection, a high-rise building is a building with height over how much? The choices are 23 meters, 50 meters, 20 meters, or 15 meters. 23 meters will be our first answer because it was mentioned in NEC 2017. However, NEC 2017 does not have a specific definition of a high-rise building. According to NEC 2017 Article 512.2, a high-rise building is defined as a building greater than 75 feet or 22.86 meter in height, where the building height is measured from the lowest level of fire department vehicle access to the floor level on the highest occupable story. However, as of now, I am looking at PEC 2017 and I don't come to read the height of the building What I found in the Philippine National Building Code of the Philippines is, or PD 1096, and it states that a building over 15 meters is required to have a lightning protection system installed as per Philippine Standard for Lightning Protection, or we call PS64-2017. Our final answer based on the question is a high-rise building in the Philippines is 15 meters. The third PEC review question reads, which of the following wires is applicable for underground service entrance conductors? Is it type THWN, type UF, type MI, type USE? Let me explain each wire. THWN is a thermoplastic wire that is rated for use in wet location, but it is not suitable for use as an underground service entrance conductors. It is commonly used for general wiring purposes and is suitable for use in conduits. UF means underground feeder cable. It is especially designed for the use underground, but it is not suitable for use as an underground service entrance conductor. It is commonly used for outdoor lighting and other outdoor electrical applications, okay? Type MI, or what we call mineral insulated cable, is a type of wire that is designed for use in high temperature application, such as in industrial setting. It is not typically used for underground service entrance conductors. So, type USE, underground service entrance cable, is especially designed for use as underground service entrance conductors. It has a tough, moisture-resistant jacket that protects the conductor from damage in underground insulation. It is commonly used as underground residential service entrances. From the selection, the type of wire applicable to underground service entrance conductor is type USE. The answer is letter D. This is PEC review question number 4. It needs your observation based on the electrical principles in your head. The question is, as a rule, no overcurrent device shall be connected in series with any conductor that is blank, stranded, current carrying, close or intentionally grounded. Let us review its once logic. A. Is stranded. This choice is incorrect because stranded conductors are conductors made up of multiple smaller wires. It is commonly used in electrical application and can be protected by overcurrent devices such as fuses or circuit breakers. B. Is current carrying. This choice is incorrect. All conductors that are part of an electrical circuit are current carrying, and overcurrent devices are specially designed to protect these conductors from damage due to excessive current. C. Is close. This choice is also incorrect. This is not clear what is meant by close in this context, but overcurrent devices can be used to protect any type of conductor or circuit that may be subject to overcurrent conditions. D. Is intentionally grounded. This is the correct choice. An intentionally grounded conductor is one that is connected to the ground through an intentional grounding path, such as grounding electrode system. Overcurrent devices should not be connected in series with intentionally grounded conductors because doing so can result in unintentional disconnection of the grounding path, which can create hazardous condition. This requirement is outlined in PEC 2017 Article 2.50, Grounding. The answer should be letter D. No overcurrent device shall be connected in series with any conductor that is intentionally grounded. Here is another question you may encounter, and it's question number 5. So, the question is, compliance with the provision of PEC will result in 1. Freedom from hazard, 2. Good electrical service, 3. An efficient system. Selection can be all three, one and two, two only, or only one? Since every selection sounds positive, letter A is the correct answer because compliance with the Philippine Electrical Code is important to ensure freedom from hazard, good electrical service, and an efficient system. The Philippine Electrical Code provides guidelines and standards for the safe installation and maintenance of electrical system, and following these guidelines can help to prevent accident and ensure that electrical system is functioning properly. Well, we are on number 6. Our number 6 question is commonly appearing in Master's Electrician's Review. It reads, for all land-based electrical installation under the scope of the Philippine Electrical Code, where should an electrical permit be filed? The selection is tricky because they are all interrelated, like Department of Energy, Office of the City Engineer, Office of the Mayor, and the local building office. For all land-based electrical installation under the scope of the Philippine Electrical Code, an electrical permit should be filed with the local building of office. PEC guidelines and standards for the safe installation and maintenance of electrical system in the Philippines and compliance with this regulation is mandatory. The local building office or office of the building official is responsible for enforcing the PEC within their jurisdiction and issuing electrical permits for land-based electrical installation. It is important to file an electrical permit before starting any electrical work to ensure that the installation is in compliance with PEC and that it meets safety standard. Our question number 7 is just familiarization about distances of aerial cable. The questions read, aerial cable under non-metallic extension shall have a clearance of blank not less than from steel structure members or other conductive materials. Actually, I want to revise the questions for clarity. Here is the revised question for clarity purposes. The aerial cable, when used with non-metallic extension, must maintain a clearance of no less than blank from steel structural members or other conductive materials. Is it 60 mm, 30 mm? 50 mm or 40 mm? The correct answer is letter C, 50 mm. This is a requirement specified by the Philippine Electrical Code regarding the installation of aerial cables under non-metallic extension. The minimum clearance specified is intended to prevent any electrical arcing or other hazard caused by the proximity of the cable to conductive materials. The 50 mm clearance is important to provide enough distance for the heat to dissipate and to prevent the boxes from getting too hot. Okay? Here is our number 8 question, which is easy, but you need to know the reason in every choices. The question is, what is the compliance requirement of the Philippine Electrical Code for government bodies exercising legal jurisdiction over electrical installation? Is it advisory, mandatory, optional, or professional? Let me explain each one before I answer. Advisory, this term implies that the compliance requirement is simply a recommendation or suggestion. In this case, government bodies may or may not choose to follow the guidelines as they are not legally binding. However, this is not the case for the Philippine Electrical Code as it sets the mandatory minimum requirement for electrical installation in the Philippines. Mandatory. This term means that compliance with Philippine Electrical Code is legally required. Government bodies exercising jurisdiction over electrical installation must adhere to the guidelines and enforce the provision of the Philippine Electrical Code. This ensures the safety, reliability, and efficiency of electrical system in country. Optional. This term implies that compliance with Philippine Electrical Code is left to the discretion of the governmental bodies involved. they may choose to follow the code, but they are not legally required to do so. This is not the case for PEC as it is mandatory code in the Philippines. Professional. This term suggests that compliance with PEC is expected only from professionals in the field of electrical installation. While professionals are indeed expected to follow the code, it is the responsibility of the government body to enforce and ensure compliance with PEC. In this sense, the term professional does not accurately describe the compliance requirement of the PEC for government bodies. I hope I explained all the choices and we have the right answer, which is mandatory. Because the government bodies exercising jurisdiction over electrical installation must adhere to the guidelines and enforce the provision of the Philippine Electrical Code. Mandatory. Here's another tricky question because you see two materials commonly used in the code. The questions read, the blank material type of conductor used to carry the current required by PEC unless otherwise specified. Is it aluminum, copper, steel, or silver? Let me explain its one so that we can defend our position. Aluminum. While aluminum conductors are lighter and less expensive than copper, they have lower conductivity but higher resistance. They can be used in some application, but they are not primary material type specified by the PEC. Copper. Copper is preferred conductor material in PEC due to the high electrical conductivity, low resistance, and excellent durability. It is the standard choice for carrying current in most electrical installations. Steel conductors have much higher resistance and lower conductivity compared to copper and aluminum. They are primarily used for mechanical support in overhead power lines or as a ground conductor, but not for carrying current in most electrical installations as per Philippine Electrical Code. Silver has the highest electrical conductivity of all the elements, but it is not used for wiring due to its high cost and limited availability. While it may be used in a specialized application, it is not the primary conductor material required by the Philippine Electrical Code. So, copper is the answer. It's always the required material specified by the Philippine Electrical Code. Well, I'm on now question number 10. And here is our last questions for the day. Keyword here is minimum distance, open method, exposed to physical damage. The questions read, what is the minimum distance from the floor at which conductor used in open wiring method are considered exposed to physical damage as per Philippine Electrical Code? Is it 3 meters, 2.5 meters, 2 meters, or 1.8 meters? Well, the correct answer is letter C. The Philippine Electrical Code states that conductors used in open wiring method within 2 meters from the floor shall be considered exposed to physical damage. This means that the conductor are at a height where they may be subjected to damage from physical contact such as by people or object passing by. And to minimize the risk and damage and ensure safety, the Philippine Electrical Code requires that conductors at this height must be protected, such as by using raceway or other protective covering. This is to prevent any electrical hazards that may result from a damaged conductor, such as electrical shock or fire. You learned so much today. Why not take some problems in our model review app? The strategy that we apply to the problem that we solve here has a lot of application, and you will find that some problems are easy to solve and guess the correct answer. In our online review for RME, you need to take as many problems as possible to pass the board exam for RME. So at least we encourage 100 questions per day. Okay? Good luck. Take more review exam on our objective type questions or calculation problems in our online review program app application platform. Once you learn seriously the topic we have discussed, the rest of the exam will be easy because you have a tool to use. See you in the next review notes. For now, you can subscribe in this channel to keep you updated, or you can visit my Facebook page and like us to support the Master's Electricians Review.